Ruahi Saram. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his doors are always open, my respectable ones in Islam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is either, number one, when you ask him, is either Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just present to you or bless you with what you are asking for. That is number one. And in essence, you will see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has answered your call or your prayer. So number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you your desire, what you are asking for. Number two, is either Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will use it and protect you from evils on this dunya. Maybe something evil or bad was to happen to you. There was going to be a tribulation that will set upon you. Because of your prayer or your supplications, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will use it and then protect you from that accident. So in that case, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered your prayer again, but you are not aware. You are thinking that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't answer your prayer. And then the last one is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will prepare it for you on the day of Qiyamah. When you come, he will show it to you. When you come on the day of Qiyamah, here Allah Azza wa Jalla will show it to you. You supplicated to me, and I prepared that which you were asking for you in this Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give it to you, and then you will love it. All this will be successful, my respectable ones in Islam, when you are patient. But if you are not patient, you will be fed up with praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, wasta'inu bis-sabr was-salah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, inna allaha ma'as-sabirin. Still, in endurance, or with patience, in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one has to be patient, to endure a lot in his da'wah, if he's a da'i, a preacher, someone who called onto the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You need to have patience. You need to have patience. For all the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this was what they had in front of them before embarking on da'wah. All of them, their people tortured them. They belied them. They denied them. But they endured. They endured. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala advised our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the glorious Quran that wasbir nafsaka ma'a alladhina wasbir kama sabara ulul azmi min ar-rusul. That be patient. Like the chosen messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how they were patient, how they endured in their services to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be patient like them. Be patient among them. كَمَا صَبَرَ عُلِ الْعَزْمِ مِنَ الرَّسُلِ. And here, my respectable ones in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again in Surah Al-An'am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that قَدْ يَعْلَمُ إِنَّهُ لَيَحْزُنُكَ الَّذِي يَقُولُونَ فَإِنَّهُمْ لَا يُكَذِّبُونَكَ وَلَكِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ يَجْهَدُونَ وَلَقَدْ كُذِّبَتْ رُسُلٌ مِّن قَبَلِكَ فَصَبَرُوا عَلَى مَا كُذِّبُوا وَأُوذُوا حَتَّى أَتَاهُمْ نَصُرُنَا وَلَا مُبَدِّلَ لِكَلِمَاتِ اللَّهِ وَلَقَدْ جَاءَكَ مِنْ نَبَإِ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَدْ يَعْلَمُ إِنَّهُ لَيَحْزُنُكَ الَّذِي يَقُولُونَ. You Muhammad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that what the people are saying grieves you. What they are saying distresses you. What they are saying hurts you, it bothers you, it hurts you. قَدْ يَعْلَمُ إِنَّهُ لَيَحْزُنُكَ الَّذِي يَقُولُونَ فَإِنَّهُمْ لَا يُكَذِّبُونَكَ. It is not you that they are denying. It is not your faithfulness. It is not your truthfulness that they are questioning. However, ولكن الظالمين بآيات الله يجحدون. The wrongdoers, those who have transgressed against themselves, they are disputing and they are denying the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah says, ولكن الظالمين بآيات الله يجحدون. ولقد كذبت رسل من قبل. So, if you are distressed, if you are bothered because you think they are belying you and they are denying you, you are not the first person that they are denying. If you don't know, you are not the first person that they are belying or they are denying. لَقَدْ كُذِّبَتْ رُسُلٌ مِّن قَبْلِكَ. Indeed, certainly, they have denied and they have belied so many messengers before you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But what did they have? What did they do? فَصَبَرُوا. They were patient. They endure in their stupidness. They endure with their stupidness, their foolishness. They endured all. They stood firm in their services to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَصَبَرُوا. وَأُوذُوا. And not only that, and they were tortured. They were harmed. Subhanallah. Some of the prophets, my respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us. Some of them, after denying them, they used to kill them. They used to kill them. وَيَقْتُلُونَ النَّبِيِّينَ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ. Especially the Bani Israel. They used to kill their prophets. They used to kill them. Prophet Idris, alayhi salatu wasalam, he was killed. They used to kill some of their prophets. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa'udhu. And they were tortured. Hatta till atawun nasruna, our help came to them. Till we, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, help them. Wala mubaddila li kalimati Allah. No one can alterate or can alter the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَقَدْ جَاءَكَ مِنْ نَبَئِ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. Indeed, the information about the prophets or the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has come to you. So be patient. Be patient. Respectable ones in Islam, Allah again told him, وَاصْبِرْ وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. And it's to all of us, الْعِبْرَةُ بِعُمُومِ اللَّغْضِ لَا بِحُصُوصِ السَّبَبِ. Even though it was directed to him, but it was for all of us. The advice is for all of us. So Allah is telling us, wasbir, be patient. وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. But let not your patience be for anyone except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be patient exclusively for Allah azza wa jal, my respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam. Wasbir. وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. My respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, this is الصَّبْرُ عَلَى طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ. Patient in the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, there is no one who can observe salah properly without patience. If you don't have patience, if you don't have patience, you can't observe salah properly. You can't worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala properly. That's why we see some people, when they stand up to observe salah, they observe it lazily, as if they are running after them, they are chasing them. Especially the munafiqun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about them. That لا يأتون الصلاة إلا وهم قسالى. That they do not observe their salah except they observe it with laziness. You see them up to observe salah. Some people, subhanallah, they observe it even if they were those that are taxed to accept the deeds or the worships of the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will not have accepted that particular praise that they themselves have observed. Yes, they will observe the salah. And so Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us in hadith that there are some people, after finishing or completing their salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will rub it and throw it upon them. The salah will tell them, ضيعك الله كما ضيعتني. Subhanallah. Allah should make you miserable like you have made me. Allah should make you miserable like you have made me. Like the way you made, you observe me. So my respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, الصبر على طاعة الله. Patience in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is number one. The second category or type of patience, الصبر عن معصية الله. Patience in abstaining from sinning against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is also another type of patience. Wallahi, without patience, one cannot abstain from the prohibitions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah tells you, don't drink, do not drink. It is not that you don't have the zeal or the desire to drink, or you cannot drink. You have all. Probably, you can even drink more than those who drink. But because Allah tells you not to drink, you abstain yourself from it. That is patience. Allahu Akbar. It is not that you will not derive some satisfaction when you engage in illegal sexual activity. You will also drive that satisfaction, and you will also satisfy that your desire. But because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibits you, you abstain yourself from it, my respectable ones in Islam. So many things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, don't do this. Don't do that. Don't do this. And you abstain yourself from it. Not because you cannot do it, but because of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, the third one is الصبر في ابتلاء أو على ابتلاء الله أو على البلاء. Tribulations, tests, in terms of tribulations and tests of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests you, you have to be patient. You have to observe patience. There was a woman who lost her son and was crying. Prophet came and asked her to endure. Just have some patience. The man was still crying. You're asking me to be patient? When I lost my beloved, when I lost this, when I lost that. She cried. She cried to her satisfaction. So the Prophet left. Later, when she realized that there was nothing to do again, she said, like we do in the Bible, when they lost hope, then they will not leave it to Allah. So the woman said, I leave it to Allah. Let me now exercise patience. So the Sahaba told him, do you know the one who was asking you to endure, to observe patience? He said, no. He said, that was perfect. So they told her that patience, true patience, is in the first place. The first time that they were asking you, or they were telling you to observe some patience, that was the time that it was required from you. But now, this is not patience. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us, my respected ones in Islam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He tests you, by qabdi ida walada, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests you by taking your son, your beloved son, or your daughter, or your soulmate, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the angels, have you taken the soul? Have you taken the soul of his son, or her son, or his daughter, or her daughter, or his soulmate, her beloved one, his beloved one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then ask them, what did my servant, what did he say after taking his beloved away from him? What did he say? The angels will tell Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he said, Alhamdulillah. He praises you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell the angels, build a house in paradise, and then they will name the house of Alhamdulillah for that person. So they will build a house for you, my respectable ones in Islam. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, and you end here, you observe some patience, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will build a house for you in paradise. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that He is with the patient one. Those who observe patience. Inna Allaha ma'a sabirin. Allah is with those who observe patience. So Ramadan will make you acquire this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in Surah Al-Baqarah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will certainly test us. He will test us. And believers, we need to understand that Allah tests you based on your faith. Allah tests you based on your faith. If your level of iman is high, the level of your test is high. If your level of iman is high, the level at which, or the rate at which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test you is also high. And that will also determine your reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If your test is huge, is great, your reward is great. And if your test is just small, is something minor, your reward is minor, it's small. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that in Hadith al-Qudus, that those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test most are the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-anbiya, because they have the highest rank of faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah said, ثُمَّ الصَّالِحُونَ, after them, then the good doers, the pious ones, ثُمَّ الْأَمْثَلْ, after them, those who try to imitate them. We are those that he's referring to. ثُمَّ الْأَمْثَلْ, after them, those who also try to imitate them. So if your level of iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is high, your test is high, and your reward is high. Your reward is high. We all know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested his prophets. Prophet Ayyub alayhi salatu wa salam, Allah tested him. He was blessed with so many risks, provisions, wealth, so many wives, so many children. One day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the story is very broad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took everything away from him. The risk, the wealth, the provision, the wives, the children, they all died. And those wives that he had, subhanAllah, some of them left. Why? Because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had tested him only by taking those provisions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided for him, that was okay. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him with marad, sickness, severe one. To the extent that all his body, it was going. I don't know the scientific term or word that I will use for this. But he stated that all his body, like, let me just leave it that. The word is not coming. Till the people asked him, some of his people, subhanAllah, are you not the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Why not ask Allah to grant you shifa? Why not ask Allah to grant you shifa? Prophet Ayyub alayhi salatu wa salam told them that I am very shy to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant me shifa as long as I have not stayed in this my sickness for so long as I stayed when I was healthy. That is very shy to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant him shifa. Because he was having good health for so many years. For so many years, but he stated in Tariq that he was sick for 18 years. So imagine, 18 years, and he was lying down. He was lying down. And the only prayer Prophet Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam made was that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should protect his heart and in the tongue so that he will use it to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That was the only thing. Allah should protect the heart so that it can still remember Allah. Protect the tongue, it can still praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described him as Sabira, ni'mal abdu innahu awwab. That he has established the highest form of patience. Such a wonderful servant. Innahu awwab. My respected elders, brothers and sisters in this world. Because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala retained all that he took away from him in supplements. Allah retained all and advanced him more in the provisions, in the wealth, in the children, and the wives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala retained all to him. My respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said he will test us. In Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah said, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُم مُّصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَّبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, wala. My respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, it's not necessary for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to use the particle or article of strength in addressing us. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to use it. وَكَلَامُ رَبِّنَا بِدُونِ تَأْكِيدِ تَأْكِيدًا. That the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord, itself, is strength itself. So even if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not use those things. But here in this very verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, wala. Allah swore by himself. Allah swore by himself. And then use lam ta'kid ayyub. La. Certainly. Surely. Indeed. Nabluwannakum, I will test you. So we should know this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test us. Allah said he will test us. Be shaken with something min al-khawf, from fear. From fear. Allah will test us from fear. That's why today, even the person you are standing with in salah, in the same row you are standing with, that person is not safe from your evil. The person you are standing closer to, you are standing with in salah, is afraid of you. That's why today, people are going into masajid, into mosques, and they are holding their sandals. Because of their fear. People are going into masajid, and they are holding their sandals. And there are so many reasons why they are holding their sandals. The very commonest one is, they might come out, and then they need not see the sandals again. The second one is, we are in the world of fear. They believe that if they leave it outside, those who plot evils against him or against him might come and use the sandals for something. This reminds me something. Back at SHS, there was this theft case of sandals. When people come to observe their salah and leave the sandals outside, after the salah, they will not see it again. So they complain. We had a chunk of complaint about that. So I decided to speak on that. It was between Maghrib and Isha. I delivered that lecture. Wallahi, after delivering that lecture and observing Isha prayer, the one who delivered the lecture came out and could not find the sandals.
Oh.
By the time I came out, I had to walk. I had to walk barefooted.
Oh.
I put it to my dormitory without sandals. Meanwhile, it was on that particular day. In fact, that hour, I delivered that lecture. This is fear. That's why you cannot leave your bike without locking it. That's fear. Allah will test us with fear. That's why today. Now it's even better. Sometime ago, before we have elections, we all know what usually happens. During the elections, people will be running. They will be burning houses, killing people. Fear. All this because of the lack of the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or because we refuse to obey Allah azza wa jal. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, those fears upon us. That was this sahaba, Silatul Nasi. This sahaba used to observe night prayer. Tahajjud. Even if he and the other sahabas were going for ijihad, he never missed that salah or that ninth prayer. One night, they were going for a jihad, and then they were in the middle of the forest on one particular night. The sahabas were resting. He decided to yande go away and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He went away, he was observing the salah, two rakah.